Hello, friends. So this is a battle that I need to win. I was not expecting this force to attack me this soon. I'm sieging a settlement. I was rather hoping they wouldn't, but they are. And the AI predicts a defeat. I'm looking at nearly 2-to-1 odds, meaning they have almost twice the number of soldiers. It's like 1.5, 75, thereabouts. So it's going to be tough. I'm not sure if I'm going to win it, but I'm confident. I have something that I'm hoping all of you will find a bit of a treat, some kind of a rarity. I don't remember seeing it before when I was playing this game regularly, so I'm thinking it might be some sort of download content that came out sometime over the last several months. Bear with me. My machine's pretty quick. It'll load fast. It'll probably take me longer to deploy.
I advise caution. We do not yet know our enemy.
But these three here have been fighting together for the better part of their lives. All of their adult lives. They're all in their 50s. And let's just say this. You wouldn't want to be an opposing army. The way that experience works in this game is that it stacks over time. So you want to keep the same units, even if they're not as advanced as other units. Some units have the ability to upgrade, not all do. The reason you want to keep them and keep the units you have and keep them together is because not only do they stack, but they compound on each other. So like, if you have a unit that has, if you have like a, say like a squad that has one really experienced unit, a couple of like so-so experienced unit, and like some, and like the rest of the units have no experience, what'll happen is it'll even it out. Mathematically. So you won't in actuality have like one super unit. It'll disperse to all the rest of the units. As you would expect, if you had like one unit that was like really, really good and like all their units you're on, it's kind of like get bolstered up by their skill, experience, and courage. But if you have a bunch of them, then they maintain more of their individual experience, and it shows. They don't run under the same conditions other units would run under. They will attack things other units won't attack. They maintain their formation better. They're just general all-around better fighters. I normally allow you to skip this, but I wanted you to see the numbers. They're pretty significant. However, we are running like 4 minutes here. This is rather lengthy, and I'm even getting a little tired. So I'll probably cut this section out. If not, I hope you like my preamble ramble. I do play it with like everything jacked up to ultra. I'm pretty sure it comes through, but hence the fact that this is taking a while. And there's gonna be a lot of units.
Never All right. underestimate anyone who may affect your designs.
Okay, let's see what the landscape is like. So we are looking at water. That's good. That's good. All right. Oh, nice. They're going to be slowed down coming after me, because they're going to have to walk through these natural land formations, which are going to actually help me out. Straighten out that line too. The deployment phase is like super important, probably like the most important part of the battle, because, well, it sets you up for like the battle, and being poorly deployed will make a battle end very quickly. I had a really nice battle yesterday. I wish I'd filmed that, actually, of me fighting a different sort of battle. It was actually, I had to attack. I wasn't, and I'm attacking here, but what I meant is, like, I had to attack. It wasn't me being able to set up formation. I had to actually go and attack an enemy formation. And I essentially enveloped them, which is kind of a complex move. And, difficult to do with three different sections of your army, but it's possible. And there were a lot of cool land formations that allowed me to do that sort of thing. What I'm doing here is a little bit different than what I've done before, and you'll see in a second why, I think, because I have something now that I didn't know you could have. And I'm pretty psyched about it. Alright, this is the only place that really has anything even remotely like a plane for the horses, because I don't want to break the horses' legs going through that. It's going to wreak havoc on cavalry. Okay, so Tao. I'll make him unit one. I want to have more control over my generals that I've been having. I'm grouping in with the units, and that's great and all, but when you want to be able to call on them, like at a moment's notice. Now this is what I'm hoping will be the surprise. Yes! See, I'm on an elephant. Now we're talking. Check that out. This should really, really put like the fear of death into enemy units. Okay, now time to deploy these things. Very important. These you want to deploy right up on your unit. And I like to make sure that I get it like right to the edge almost. Oil. See, what this does here, when you're able to actually like set up this formation, is it's going to discourage them, the enemy units, going anywhere but essentially where I want them to go, which is down this funnel of death. That let us start the battle.
Archers! Ready! At the ready! Cavalry, attack! Look out! Enemy reinforcements are here!
Expected better.
You speak well for an infant.
Oh!
So the elephant. The elephant in the room, as they say. I really can't wait to see the effect it has on troops. Now, I need to keep it away from spearmen, but most swordsmen, the sword won't be able to get through its hide. It'll run right over them. Really? Alright, that's foolish. Well, Moyos, I believe I've got fire arrows now. Oh, I need to have it. I think I need to have them grouped. But if I group these guys, I should have fire arrows. My bad. Interesting. It's not something I expected. I should have fire arrows. At any rate, that's something for another time. That is interesting. The reason I bring it up is they're mostly spearmen. What I'm going to do is, I believe the border for this map is somewhere over here. I'm just gonna take these guys. I'm gonna do this. Let's avoid the water. The water will slow them down. And then the reason I'm doing that is I want to get those archers back there. The artillery.
Come on, surely you can do better.
Focus your efforts on the enemy, perhaps.
Nearest dry land corridor. There. time to toss the caltrops. I might tire my horses out a bit, but tired's better than dead. It's killing me. I need to do something I don't want to do. This wheel here, the three of you. Elephants have an attendant effect. They're all afraid of him. Oh, there's Fleming shot. I just had to wait until the battle started. I have to do two different types of... I must have two different types of archers. No.
Warriors, run! Craven dogs! Thank you. our warriors run. Traitor dogs.
enemy unit flees! What cowards!
War has brought you to the very gates of your enemy. Behind their walls, they steel themselves against your armies. They cannot hold out forever. Yet an assault may be costly if not swift. Yet wait too long, and reinforcements may arrive to relieve their embattled comrades. New
justice cannot be denied
from the labors of their forebears. Life springs eternal.
The elephant is ridiculous.
Wisdom and effort has given way to the renewal of life. A birth in your family. And the continual...
Whoa! All right. I hope you enjoyed that. I know it was good for me.